Hugh's been the one consistent element in the entire X-Men franchise. What are we going to see from the Wolverine that's maybe a little different from what we've seen from Logan and his performance before?
You're going to see him go further in all respects. You know, so in terms of his emotional and psychological, the detailing of his state of mind is much more richly drawn, I think, than we've ever seen. We have a better intimate understanding of who he is and where he's coming from. And as a result, I think when you see him challenged in the ways that he's challenged, I'm sorry to be elliptical, but when you see that, I think it's more powerful. I think it's more compelling. The victories are more personal, and therefore, I think, more impactful in the end.
Of course, fans are very excited about Days of Future Past. How much of a force is Hugh going to be in that? Because in the original comic, he was kind of a very pivotal main character. Obviously, in First Class, he only had a very brief cameo. How much screen time are we seeing for Hugh in that?
He's in it stem to stern.
We're seeing a combination of the original trilogy and the First Class iteration of X-Men. How do you think those two are combining? What have been the challenges, and what are you most excited about?
Look, it's been a challenge because it's such a big cast, and it's a lot of actors to bring together in one place and figure out how to manage all their schedules and things like that, because they're all sort of stars in their own right. It's probably the single most gifted cast of actors I've ever been anywhere near in 25 years. But the prospect of that, I think, has both been wonderful to see them all work together, and I think for the franchise, it's incredibly exciting to see how they interact and how the two different casts marry is extraordinary. And I think what it bodes for the future and for the future of the franchise is really great.
In terms of the future of the franchise, do you see this as a way of unifying the original trilogy with the First Class kind of alternate timeline, or is it a case of the X-Men First Class trilogy is going to continue and there might be sequels effectively following on with the modern generation of X-Men?
Well, I think what's exciting is it can be both. I think, you know, the nature of this project is they intersect and the legacy can be unique and different for both casts, together and separately. So there's a tremendous amount of opportunity that comes out of it.
We're seeing a lot of familiar characters returning, but we're also seeing some new characters, particularly people like Quicksilver. What excites you about those characters? Are there any in particular that you think fans are going to respond to especially well?
I think they're going to respond to all the new characters well, and there are actually quite a few. Quicksilver's gotten the most attention, I think, but no, it's always exciting when you've got new young actors coming into something like this, new powers, a new orientation in terms of what that specific character's situation is, who they are as they come into the storyline. It's refreshing for a franchise that has so many we know. As soon as you introduce new ones, it's kind of fun, and it changes the alchemy of the scenes, it changes the storyline a little bit. So for all those reasons, it's been really fun and exciting, I think particularly for Brian, to be honest.
Of course, I think fans are especially excited by the prospect of seeing our X-Men First Class characters reuniting with their older namesakes. Are we actually going to get to see much face time between the two generations? Do they interact directly?
Well, I won't give too much away, but I won't promise, but I will suggest that is a likely possibility.
Bringing it back to this film, beyond Hugh's astonishing performance, what can fans expect from the Wolverine overall? What do you think James has done with the franchise?
I think James has advanced it, simply. I think he's taken us further than we've ever gone in terms of his commitment to creating characters and situations we care about. Not just that we come to because they're well marketed and because they're big and loud and sort of sexy things to go see, but because he's created a story that will be enduring. And that I think, in honoring the underlying comic, has taken us on a journey that I don't think I've seen the likes of in these films. So hopefully by making a great film, which I think he has, that's kind of your best insurance for the future. I also think Hugh's performance, what it's offered him, is the opportunity to do more with the character than he's ever done. And that's, you know, for a guy who's done it as many times as he has and as accomplished as he has, that in and of itself represents to me a major accomplishment, and he's done a superb job.
Speaking about an accomplishment, for a Japanese-based adventure, you couldn't have brought together a better Japanese cast. Can you talk a little bit about some of the faces we're seeing on that side of the equation?
Yes, incredibly blessed. I mean, both in terms of our newcomers and our established actors, in part because I think we've been unique in going to Japan and drawing on so many Japanese actors for our cast. But again, one of the benefits of having an actor, a director of Jim's caliber, is that his instincts with actors is superb, second to none. And that means that he's chosen the best of the best to help surround and inhabit this world. And again, you'll be the judge yourself, but we're incredibly proud of what they've done. Newcomers, and obviously, you know, an actor like Hiro is you're blessed to have him in your cast at any time.
Looking to the future, of course, I mean, Hugh, we're going to see a lot of him in Days of Future Past. Is this the last time we're going to see a solo Wolverine adventure? Do you think this is the definitive Wolverine movie, or are we potentially going to see more of Hugh on his own as well?
Look, it certainly would be my hope you're going to see more of Hugh alone. I think it's sort of more of a studio question than it is for me, but I do think this film should establish the opportunity to maintain a separate track in conjunction with doing the ensemble pieces that have so characterized the franchise. So my hope is you will see this as the beginning of what will be many, many for Hugh if he chooses to keep coming back.